So check it out. Say that someone's got some major low back pain come on. Or say that you have some debilitating, you know, neck pain or headaches or any type of pain whatsoever. What are you gonna do? Because you have a couple options out there. But again, the likelihood of someone experiencing pain here is pretty high. I mean, when you look at just headaches alone, you have a 52% chance you're gonna get it in your life. You have a 70% chance you're gonna get back pain in your life, and you have 21% chance you're gonna get neck pain. So obviously pain is a huge thing going on. This is just the US alone. Millions and millions of people. But again, the options you have is really to go the chiropractic route or the medical care route. You really have two types of options. And when you're looking at the available therapies, medical care, they practice allopathically. They're gonna work with the two tools they have in their toolbox, drugs and or surgery. Whereas chiropractors, we do more wellness and prevention. We're gonna basically correct misalignments, subluxations, in order to increase the function of the body, the function of the nervous system, so your body can heal itself properly and function optimally. Now, I know this talk is centered around pain, because the reality is, when we get new patients here, people come in with pain that brings them here, either as a first resort or a last resort when the medical system has failed them. So chiropractic is not about pain, it's about increasing the function of the body. But if you increase the function of the body, if someone's functioning optimally, do they have pain? No. So a side effect of chiropractic is pain relief, but we're not aimed at reducing pain. We're aimed at increasing function. So again, we have to look at a little history before I start here, because what inspired me to do this is all the crap medical doctors talk about chiropractors, calling us quacks, which is cool, because when you see the research, I'd rather be called a quack all day than do what they do. But calling us quacks, calling us a profession that has no scientific evidence. Because the reality is, we have so much scientific evidence, it's not even funny. People just are not aware of the scientific evidence. And that's where I come in, to educate you guys on what the evidence shows, so you guys can use this at your arsenal. And again, chiropractors were jailed for practicing medicine without a license. And again, we don't even practice medicine. We're the only healthcare profession out there, it's like, that does not prescribe drugs, yet we were jailed for practicing medicine. Why? Because we are competition to their crap. But again, let's look at the research here. Because again, the AMA, the American Medical Association in the 70s, they actually tried this smear campaign to destroy the chiropractic profession. And it actually went to the Supreme Court. It's called Wilk versus AMA. And of course, chiropractic won. But it still is going on. All the smear campaigns, everything, because big pharma now owns everything. That's what our healthcare system is based on. It's prescription care healthcare. And that's why we're the sickest developed nation on earth. The sickest developed nation on earth, when we consume more drugs than the next five countries combined. So, when you look at the scientific evidence, you're gonna do two things. Medicine is gonna do a couple different things. They're gonna prescribe you opioids if you have pain. Muscle relaxants, NSAIDs. They're gonna refer you out for surgery and or refer you out to physiotherapy. That's really the only thing they got up their sleeves that they can do. And we're gonna look at all of those, and then we're gonna look at chiropractic. So the first one's great. This is their go-to. You come in with pain, they're gonna wanna give you opioids. They're number one. You're talking the morphine, oxycontin, oxycodone, fentanyl, Percocet, Vicodin, all of that, you name it. And so when you look at the research, most of these articles I'm gonna be referencing is out of the Spine Journal, which is probably one of the best peer-reviewed journals out there. Now, on this article, first of all, opioid addiction is a huge epidemic. And this is the crazy thing. This is their number one go-to. Give you opioids. And what's their number one outcome goal that they can hope for when you take these opioids? Numbness. That's the best thing a medical doctor can hope for that this drug does for you. So the only thing they got up their sleeves is to give you a freaking drug to numb you. Okay? That's all they have. And this is scientific evidence. But look, it doesn't heal you. doesn't restore function. It's not going to restore neurology. It's not going to restore motion. It's not going to do any of this. And in fact, 59% of patients on opioids for less than 3 months period of time, they're going to experience adverse effects. But then if you go over that 3 month, boom, you're up to 90% likelihood that you're going to experience adverse effects. Now, I know what you're thinking. What are these adverse effects? And I'm glad you asked, because they like this one. Well, it's going to cause your bowel system to completely shut down. Constipation. I don't know if you guys have seen this ad on the TV for opioid-induced constipation. They have another drug for you. So this has all these symptoms and side effects, and now you can take another drug to fight those. It's awesome, you know? And they actually say that on the frickin' ad. It's like, you guys are unbelievable how stupid these people can be. But again, you're gonna completely shut down your digestive system, so you're gonna go on all these other drugs. Erectile dysfunction. Now you're gonna be put on Viagra. That's the next thing they're gonna prescribe you. Low energy, you're gonna be easily fatigued, you're gonna be a frickin' zombie. Have you seen people addicted to opioids? Yeah. Huh? What? Yeah, exactly. Okay, altered menstrual cycle, females. It's gonna destroy everything. Osteoporosis, and I forgot one. Death. Wow, how could I forget that one, okay? So death. So these are the adverse effects of their number one treatment for frickin' pain that we have. No wonder we're the sickest nation on earth, okay? This is crazy. And again, at the expense for what outcome? Numbness. Numbness. So you have to look at addiction and withdrawal when you're talking about opioids, because it should be noted in the article that 40% actually experience these massive withdrawal rates. Okay, 40%. And you gotta love this, because among the remaining patients, so the remaining 60%, one third are excellent responders. That's their wording. Basically mean that they get totally stoned and numb. One third are fair responders. You know, they get a little buzz, you know, they're chilling, but they're not quite at that real numbness level. And then one third are non-responders. So when you actually look at their research, the conclusion, 40% withdrawal, the remaining two-thirds get little to no relief, and only 20% get the desired temporary pain relief. But they still get all the side effects. And again, they're not better, they're not healthier, they're just numb. Congratulations, medical doctors. You win in scientific evidence. We're the quacks, and I'll be rather be called a quack all day. Because again, from the US Surgeon General, more Americans use prescription opioids than smoke cigarettes now. That's how bad it is. But again, they're making the cheddar, so it's all good, right? Now, that's just prescribed opioids. A lot of people take this stuff, you know, unprescribed as well. We all know that. Substance abuse has now eclipsed cancer, especially opioid substance abuse, has eclipsed cancer in terms of prevalence, costs the US more than the treatment of diabetes. The sad truth, though, is that it kills more people, more Americans than car crashes. 2014 alone, these drugs killed over 49,700 Americans. So, the medical system's really good at killing people, but in terms of helping people, they don't do it. They don't do it because they can never increase the function of someone, and health is function. You know, but opioids are not the only thing they have up their sleeves. They're also gonna give you the prescription NSAIDs, the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. They're also gonna give out the muscle relaxants like candy. So let's look at the research that looks at that. Again, no evidence for long-term use. There's more central nervous system side effects compared to placebo in nearly all trials, you think? Okay. Oh, and this is great too, because once they put you on this stuff, remember, sudden discontinued use can lead to delirium tremens. That's where you completely lose your memory. You start seeing things, hearing things. You basically turn really, really crazy. Or if you stop abruptly, you can get seizures. So think about that marketing plan. We're gonna give you this stuff, but you can't stop now, because now you're gonna get seizures or delirium tremens. So they got you. Now, again, this is the sad part. Additional medications provide interesting potential treatments, but they lack rigorous trials to support their usefulness. What does that mean in English? There's no freaking evidence to support these. So when they have these drugs that there's absolutely no evidence for, what do? Well, they're using you guys as guinea pigs. It's trial and error. That's all they do, trial and error. Let me give you a good example. Who's heard of the medication Vioxx? Anyone? Yeah, that's a prescription NSAID, a COX-2 inhibitor. Basically what happened is that Vioxx was put out by this pretty evil company called Merck. And it actually got FDA approved pretty easily. You know, but the FDA will approve many things. But anyway, it's approved. Now what they notice is that most people on Vioxx started to get these fatal, you know, heart attacks, these fatal strokes. They were dying instantly. And they're thinking, wait a minute, it took over 50,000 people to be killed by this one drug alone for them to remove it off the market. So these doctors are literally murderers. They're literally just giving you these drugs that are killing massive amounts of people, over 50,000 here. I mean, when is this ever gonna stop, you know? And again, I like this wording too. The cost of side effects should also be considered. No, really, let's look in this, okay. You know, in fact, each dollar spent on these prescription drugs, an extra 66 cents was used on their side effects. So every dollar spent, 66 cents on the side effects. Now, question of the day, what do you think that 66 cents was spent on? And it's genius. More drugs with no evidence. So again, it's just like, this is unbelievable. You cannot make this stuff up, okay? So again, you got the medication, you got the pills, but this just gets better and better because now they got the surgeries. Oh. And you know, of course, if you're coming with back pain, the number one surgery is gonna be a fusion, of course. We see it all the time. And fortunately, we see it patients on their last resort, on their last leg, on their last hope, coming in here with this massive surgery, you know, needing our help. And it's like, you can't remove these screws, but you can at least give them life. I mean, that's really all you can hope for at this point. But when you're looking at this, in this article, long-term outcomes of lumbar fusion, they did a really cool thing because they took two different groups. They took patients with a similar diagnosis. So if they say they had a disc issue, they took them and they divided them into two groups. One got the surgery and one didn't. Really, really self-explanatory. So you got one group that got it, one group that did not get the surgery. Now, this is, you can't make this up. 26% of the surgery group returned to work within 2 years versus 67% who didn't have the surgery. Wow. So you're three times likely to return to work if you don't do the crap they tell you to do and get the surgery. It's like, are you serious? So if you want to die and you want to not return to work in 2 years, do what they tell you. Yeah. You know, little sheeple here. 36% of surgeries resulted in significant complications. It's getting better. 27% of those had to be reoperated on due to complications. So you had a higher rate of people being reoperated on than the people who were actually able to return to work within 2 years. Okay, so craziness. And not to mention that your likelihood of permanent disability up 500% with the surgery. So does surgery sound good to anybody? I mean, and again, with this permanent disability, with all this crap, again, you're increasing these patients who get the surgery, you're gonna increase their opioid use now by 76%. And we just covered opioid use and how scientific that is. So again, it's a perfect storm. They're just gonna be getting sicker and sicker and sicker until they're done. They have no hope and they're going to these medical doctors for help and all these guys can do is this crap. That's scientific, right? Because we're the quacks and they're the authority. Now again, another one, and this is cool because they now, you know, you hear a lot of people saying, oh, but the surgery's so advanced nowadays, you know, it's not like it, what it once was, you know? And so let's look into it because they now use this special paste to fuse the spine. I mean, it's called recombinant human bone morphogenetic protein. It's this paste they use to fuse, and it's supposed to be this the next thing since sliced bread, you know, yada, yada, yada. But this guy, the author, Carrigy, he's one of the heads of the orthopedic surgery department at Stanford. And I actually like this guy because I'm not saying all surgery is. I'm just saying 99.9% is useless, but not all of it. But this guy, he's a surgeon. He actually cares about legit scientific evidence. And he's saying, wait a minute, there's these, the 13 articles promoting all this new paste to fuse. All of them are being funded massively. They're all sponsored by the actual manufacturers of the product itself. So if, you know, that's definitely a conflict of interest. If I'm putting out this product and I do a study on it, I'm gonna try to make that product look real, real good. Okay, it's pretty obvious. And what he found out is that this paste they put around has 50 times the adverse effects than what was actually reported in the literature. So that is not actually, it's not actually getting better, it's actually getting worse. The more advanced they're getting, it's actually getting worse. And in fact, they're looking at this, and the reason is because all of the publications available were industry-sponsored, peer-reviewed publications. So if the industry funds it, it's going to be completely biased. And again, they found out, not just is it biased, they underestimated 50 times the adverse effects of these surgeries. 50 times. Not double, not triple, 50 times. Okay? And this just gets worse. The financial interest of these surgeons doing these surgeries, 12 to 16 million per study. I mean, talking about money, okay? Look at this. For all studies, okay, these guys, these financial associations, they're getting more than 10 million per study on doing this special paced fusion that is just completely useless. And we see it every day. We see it every single day. And then there's this awesome book out. It's called Surgery, the Ultimate Placebo. And basically what he says is there is very little evidence that spine fusion surgery for back pain is effective. It is very expensive. It leads to complications. Often requires further surgery. I love this one. Is associated with increased mortality. So it's going to kill you faster. Cool. Let me sign me up for that one. And it often does not even result in the spine being fused. Well, thank God it's not going to fuse it completely. But I mean, this is just such crap. The rate of spine surgery has now overtaken hip replacement surgery in terms of popularity. So this stuff is going around, but this stuff is not good. Stay away from it. And the onus is on doctors to prove that spine fusion surgery for back pain is better than placebo. Now, when you read that statement alone, they have yet to ever show that these surgeries that are making billions and billions of dollars are better than a placebo. Which means better than doing nothing. Because again, we just showed that it's actually worse than doing nothing. But if you can't prove that it's better than a placebo, there's no way this should be on the market doing that kind of stuff. And again, there's never been any sham back surgery trials. And what that means is comparing the back surgery to a placebo. There's never been any of that done. They did one with the knee surgery and they didn't like the effects. They found out that doing nothing was way better than actually getting a meniscus surgery. But you're not going to hear much about that one. But they've never done it for a back surgery. Yeah, that's all we see every day. So, right now, you're talking 500,000 plus spinal fusions a year in the U.S. alone, over $100,000 each. Multiply those together, that's a $50 billion a year business of spinal fusion surgeries. Okay? And I love this quote. Somebody is winning here, and it isn't the patients, obviously. Now, let's take into account. So you get the surgery. Well, this amount of money is not including the opioid dependence they're going to be getting, the overdoses, the likelihood of reoperation, as well as the lost wages, because if you get the surgery, you're three times less likely to return to work. So you're talking bankrupting families, you're talking all this. Easily after this, it easily surpasses over $100 billion a year. Absolutely devastating. And this is what we see. Here's some examples, some case studies. This patient comes in, she gets a three-segment fused vertebra in the reverse direction. You know, we're all about curve restoration. They fused it in the reverse direction. So now she's forced to have this spinal cord absolutely pulled, her brainstem is completely torqued, headaches massively, but guess what? Now she's addicted to opioids because she can't get off of them. And if she does, she might have a seizure because you can't get off of them. And so this is what we see every day. And again, if they want to go back to the doctor, all they're going to do is give her another freaking drug. That's their evidence-based scientific evidence. That's it. And then you look at this guy. I mean, he had a low back pain problem. And he comes out of the appointment with this. And you're looking at a low back fusion, but it's actually worse. They actually fuse the low back as well with the tailbone. Now, when you bend down, when you move, you actually need movement between those joints. So now the guy can't move at all. He's sicker than ever. He's on opioids. He's on every pill you can name. And again, what can you do? His whole entire back is fused with the sacrum, so you can't bend. You can't do anything. We can't tell him to go walk because he can't walk. It's like, this stuff is absolutely devastating. And it pisses me off. But then they can refer you to physiotherapy. And it's funny because, you know, physiotherapy modalities, you're talking, you know, roller tables, electrical stimulation, ultrasound, hot packs, cold packs, you know, lotions, potions, whatever it is, okay? But when they're looking at the evidence, you're gonna see few studies were found to support the use. You know, it's, even though it's frequently used, does not have any evidence. No evidence. Zero frickin' evidence. But what's funny is that with all these pills, with all these surgeries, with all these physiotherapy stuff that doesn't work, insurance companies are glad to compensate for that kind of stuff. They're glad to pay for the crap that doesn't work, but yet for a chiropractic that actually restores function, absolutely not. So you wonder why we're in debt. Yeah. Yeah. Obamacare, all this care, it's just, it's absolutely crap. Because insurance company, I don't even understand how they can even do this when they see the available evidence that's available to all of us. And so when you're looking at physiotherapy, we already know all their modalities don't work. They may feel good at the time, but they don't have any long-term impact. But what does have impact and what their physical therapists are starting to do now is they're adding spinal thrust manipulation into their curriculum. And this is a physiotherapy paper, okay? They're taking the one skill we have that apparently is quackery and no scientific evidence, and they're stealing it because they know it's effective. So look at this. This thing. In this paper, they actually recognize a manipulation, a spinal adjustment, as best practice. I quote, it's the best practice. You know, you don't just say best practice for no reason. So again, look at this. Thrust manipulation in the subgroups provides superior outcomes in pain and function, as well as reduced healthcare. Okay, whoa. So they can show you that we're basically the stuff in a physiotherapy paper, but if you actually say chiropractic, oh, we're awful. We do the same crap. In fact, we dedicate 4 years to mastering our ability to adjust the spine. These guys take a course in it. But yet we're the quacks. This is crazy, okay? And it gets better, okay? We have an obligation to patients. This is in a physiotherapy paper. We have an obligation to patients and to society to provide the most cost-effective outcome. Therefore, we call upon entry-level physical therapy programs to instruct spinal thrust manipulation and allow graduates to provide, love that word, best practice. We allow them to do best practice with spinal manipulation for patients with spinal impairments. Oh my Lord. So, again, nothing in physiotherapy works except the thing that they're trying to steal from us, spinal manipulation, and that's what the science shows. So now let's look at chiropractic, and here's a good fun fact. Skeptics of chiropractic, medical doctors, you know, the American Medical Association, surgeons, whoever, they have never produced a single shred of evidence showing that greater evidence for medical or physiotherapy interventions than chiropractic. Never. They cannot do it. They can never show it. They're superior. All they can do is just call us quacks. That's cool. I love ducks. So here in this report, Chiropractic Report, volume 22 in 2008, they found out that since the 70s, when they started looking into it, that chiropractic healthcare is safe, effective, cost-effective, and it's the recommended licensure. So look at those four things. It's recommended, it's safe, it's effective, and it's cost-effective. What drug, what surgery can you say even one of those? None of their crap is safe. None of it is effective, for damn sure. It's not cost effective. It costs over $100 billion a year. And, oh, I guess it's recommended by them because they're crazy. But again, crazy stuff, right? And again, a fair interpretation of the evidence indicates basically that chiropractic comes close to the best case scenario for low costs and high benefits. Wow, but we're the quacks. And it's crazy because I was just at a wedding last weekend in Palm Springs, and we didn't really know anyone there except the person getting married. And of course, we're looking at our seating chart. And when we sit down, you know, everyone's introducing ourselves, and these people are like, oh, yeah, my name's Mike, you know, and then, well, what do you do? Oh, I'm a chiropractor. And, you know, they're like, oh, man, I love chiropractic. You know, it just feels so good after my adjustment, but I only got one because I don't know if I can quite deal with the risk-benefit ratio. And I'm thinking, dude, I was ready to get up and throw down right there, you know? And my wife is trying to hold me down under the table, like, dude, don't do it. We're at a wedding. And I'm like, who's telling him this crap? It's these medical doctors. Because if he's actually reading the science, there's no way. The risk-benefit ratio? What's the risk? I'm like, dude, you're freaking crazy, all right? But anyway, that's fun. So This article is the best. It's the first ever reported randomized controlled trial comparing chiropractic care to family physician typical medical care. And of course, they found chiropractic superior, that's obvious, but let's look into it. Chiropractic spinal manipulative therapy, so the chiropractic adjustment, is associated with significantly greater improvement in condition-specific functioning. So they're saying that we get people functioning at a higher level. In this paper, in the Spine Journal, one of the best journals ever, okay, we're better at getting people to function better. Health is function. If health was how you feel, you could just drink a bottle of liquor every day and you'd be the healthiest person on earth, because I'm sure you'd feel good. But it's not how you feel, it's how you're functioning. And so again, chiropractic improves function in patients with pain significantly greater. Now, why do you think that is? And the reason is because pills, lotions, potions, surgeries, all this crap that medical doctors do, none of that help the patient. None of them get them functioning better. In fact, they all do the opposite. They downregulate function. They become more dependent. You get sicker and sicker and sicker. So they're very good at getting you sick. So if you want to get sick, go to them, okay? Multiple studies have demonstrated a poor correlation. And this is sad because there's a poor correlation between what primary healthcare providers, medical physicians, think is effective and what has actually been shown to be effective. So they think their crap is effective, but even this article shows there's a big difference between what they think is effective than what is actually effective, because they don't even read their own research. When they give pills, they don't even read the insert. When they give vaccines, they don't even know what's on the vaccine insert. They don't even know there is a vaccine insert. They don't do it. They don't do it. They don't even look at the stuff they give every day, multiple times a day. And so the last study we're gonna go over is that, again, there's beneficial effects of manipulation in comparison to a sham manipulation. Remember we talked about how they never did a back surgery trial that compared it to a sham trial to a placebo? Well, chiropractic is one of the only treatments that actually has been proven better than a placebo. Believe it or not, that's hard to do. It's hard to actually get better than doing nothing, to actually show that, because none of the medical doctor's treatments can do that. These pills don't do it. The back surgeries don't do it. And so, again, they like to call chiropractic, right? CAM, complementary and alternative medicine. Have you heard that term? Yeah, we're complementary and alternative. Well, that's bull crap, because we're not alternative, because there's no alternative to dying with surgery and drugs. There's no alternative to that. Complementary? Are you freaking kidding me? I'm not gonna compliment someone with surgery, with drugs. If anything, I'm freaking antagonistic to that crap. That's what Dr. Bergman says. We're antagonistic. We're not complementary to their crap they're giving that has no shred of scientific evidence. Get the hell out of here. And Thomas Edison knows. The doctor of the future will give no medicine, but will interest his patients in the care of the human frame, the spine, in diet, and in the cause and prevention of disease. Boom. And then Hippocrates, and this is great because he's the father of medicine, right? What does every medical doctor do? The Hippocratic Oath, which they don't even do anymore because they do way more harm than good. Anyway, it says, he actually said, look well to the spine for the cause of disease. And what does chiropractic do? There is a vast difference between treating the effects and adjusting the cause. The effects, again, are just the side effects, the symptoms. So that's what we got for you guys. Thank you for coming out. Fired up. You got arsenal. So when this goes on YouTube, you're going to have copies of all these articles. You can share them with all your friends, all your medical doctors. They'll love it. Like, oh, what article did you say that was? I haven't read that one. Yeah, you haven't read any of them. So.